Hello friends, I am Prashant. I welcome you to Educational Stuff YouTube channel. Today I will be discussing one of the articles published in the Hindu editorial. This is regarding the G7 summit. Today is 4th June 2020. Before we get into the article, we'll have a brief discussion about what is G7. G7 is a group of seven, is an international intergovernmental economic organization consisting of seven major countries: Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Japan, United Kingdom and United States. It is the largest international monetary fund advanced economies in the world at the time. As of 2018, the seven countries involved represent 58% of global net worth, that is $317 billion, and more than 46% of global gross domestic product, that is GDP, based on the nominal values. The annual G7 summit includes seven head government from these seven countries. Now, as you can see the recent news, Trump is inviting India for G7 summit. Let's get into this article. Dismissing the current configurations of the group of seven or G7 of the world's most developed nations as outdated, US President Donald Trump announced over the weekend that he would like to expand it to G11, means they are adding some of the countries to become a G11 by India, Russia, South Korea and Australia. He followed up that with the invitations to their leaders, including Prime Minister Modi, to attend G7 summit in US later this year. The news was welcomed by Mr. Modi, who commended Mr. Trump for his creative farsightedness. His decision to expand the format of grouping to keep up with the new relatives of the post-COVID world. Australia and South Korea have also welcomed the invitation, while Russia, that lost its membership in the grouping in 2014 over its annexation of Crimea, said President Putin would attend if treated as an equal, notable by its absence in the proposed grouping in China, which had earlier, along with India, Brazil, Mexico and South Africa, been invited regularly to G8 summit as an outreach by a developed world to the five emerging economies called G8+5. US-China tensions, particularly over coronavirus issues, clearly played a part in Mr. Trump's decision to leave Chinese President Xi Jinping off his summit guest list. A White House spokesperson even explained that the G11 would be a way to us to bring together its traditional allies to talk about how to deal with the future of China. Predictably, Beijing has lashed out at the G11 idea as one that would be doomed to fail. The proposed G11 grouping would recognize India's place amongst the world's richest nations and acknowledge its global view. However, the government weighed the benefits proposed along with some of the factors that are still unclear. As host, the Trump can invite any country as G7 special invitee, but changing its composition will require the proposal and approval of the other members. Already, there are some concerns over Russia, which could derail the entire G11 plan, making any concrete decision by New Delhi on the issue premature. It is unclear when the summit will actually held, given the November polls in US, although Mr. Trump has initiated that he could hold it close to UN General Assembly session in September. Despite its border tensions with Beijing, India must also consider its objectives in attending a grouping that appears aimed to be fueling a new Cold War between US and China. Finally, an evaluation of G7's effectiveness as a multilateral forum that far is needed, given deep member differences on issues including climatic change, security contributions, Iran, etc. In France last year, the grouping was unable to issue a joint communique due to the differences, first in its 45 years old. This particular article is regarding 7 to 11, means G7 to G11. India deserves its place on a global stage, but on G11 it must be clear about its aims. This is the first article discussion of today's Hindu's editorial page. If you can further see the rest of the article discussions from the description link. And before I conclude, I request you all to hit a like or subscribe to my channel. I thank your time on educational stuff. Before I conclude, I would like to say thanks for joining me. Have a great day.